Okay, so you know I'm bored anytime I'm doing this. I'm basically doing this out of the new. But I think that's positive, right? Isn't that productive? Like, if you're doing something out of the new, that means you're bored. Well, at least you're doing something that's productive. It's prolific. We're learning vocabulary. So this says ruminate. Ruminate means what? To think. To think. Ponder. All right. Dogmatic, that could be opinionated. It could be somebody that's condescending, thinking that they could be better than you, they may know more than you. And so their message is dogmatic versus really understanding you because their subjective opinion matters. So opinionated. Miserly, that could mean somebody that don't want to spend any money. Mean. Mean, all right. Deft, that means somebody skillful, a deft organist, skillful. All right, let's go over some more. Disparage, we should know that. That means what? To belittle somebody. Hospitable, somebody nice, somebody's welcoming. I think sympathetic is probably a distant synonym. So I go with the juxtaposed one or the closest one. So we're welcoming. All right. Husky. Kind of thick, rough. Okay. Archetype. That's a typical example. An embodiment. All right. Indelible. That means, uh-oh. Permanent. Like a tattoo. Some tattoos are permanent, it's indelible. Oh, can I pronounce that?
Pernicious.
Pernicious. Pernicious. I think it's knowledgeable, but don't get me. Don't hold me. No, it's harmful. I'm doing good though. I only got one wrong thus far. Jaded, that means you're tired. That's actually how I'm feeling now. Maybe that's why I miss. I didn't know, I couldn't delineate the word pernicious. But anyway, jaded is tired. We know that. Pedestrian. Somebody dull. Boring. Insurrection. Wow, then we had that on January 6th. They were rebels. A kind of classic rebellion. Here we go. High spirited. We should know that. Lively, vivacious. Gusto. All right, let's try another round. I actually do this out of the new when I'm bored. I ascertain words. I think that's awesome. I'm not going out robbing, killing nobody. I ain't raping nobody. I'm learning. All right, calumny. That is defamation. Belligerent, aggressive. Like Daryl Brooks, he was very aggressive in that courtroom. With Judge Dora, but to no avail given his custodial status. Where is he now? Exactly. So we got that right. All right. Abhor. That means you hate. You have abhorrence in your heart. Hatred. It could mean aversion. Anything that is an aversion means a hatred for something. Pernicious. Back to the same. Harmful. I remembered it. Now I got it into my memory bank. Harmful. All right. I like how this gives you the same word again, just to try to build the potentiality of your memory. Let's see here. Harmful. I don't really care for the multiple choice because sometimes the multiple choice could make it a little easier. And I like a challenge. But nevertheless, I'm still learning, and that's really the principle. All right, irreproachable, blameless. Travesty. Misrepresentation. Prune, that means the cut, the trim. I need to get my hair pruned. Now, you wouldn't hear anybody say that. Can you imagine somebody saying, I'm going to the barber shop to get my hair pruned? Who says that? But it means the same thing, and that's what I like about synonyms. Synonyms have the power to reflect the same meaning. All right, here we go. Spate. That means, uh-oh. It might be a series. I was right. Okay. Inkling. That means something you thought about, an idea. You may have had an inkling to do something. Hopefully it didn't fail. All right, let's try one more round. I know that I said that we were going to abridge. By the defugal, that means cheap. Somebody economical. That was my issue. I had issues with my car because I was being too frugal. All right, getting 87, regular gas and trying to put it in a nice expensive vehicle. You don't want to do that. Sometimes you can't always be economical because you can certainly get what you pay for. And so I had to bump it up to get quality gas to go into a quality vehicle. So this is frugal, economical. All right. Adulation. That's what I do when I go to church. I'm worshiping God. I'm in my time of adulation of Him. All right. Worship. Parley. That means a conversation, a colloquy, a confabulation. Parlance. That's even like a jargon. So this is relating to discussion. Here we go. Calumny. That means defamation. We had that. Defamation. I should say ask and answer because I know how many times am I going to define this or delineate it? Come on. Blistering. Hot. That's what I'm saving it for now, y'all. I refuse to go through another blistering summer in the absence of my air conditioner working. Okay. So we're going to get that together. It's in the working. I'll prognosticate that thing. I know that's right. I speak life to that. Unfettered. That means free. I learned that when I knew the song. There's a song that says Jesus breaks every fetter. And so that means he's coming to give us autonomy. He's coming to give us freedom. So anything that is unfettered means that it is absolute, unmitigated. So I like that. All right. Free. Autonomy. Interject, that means to interrupt. That's what Darryl Brooks was doing the entire time, which landed him in the juxtaposed courtroom because of his multiplicity of interjections and objections. How many times did he say objection? Jesus, oh my God! Possessive, that can mean somebody jealous. See, why did Darryl Brooks run over Erica Patterson? Because he was possessive. He was jealous. All right. Sanguine, that means good. No, optimistic, somebody hopeful. I like that. Cheerful, that's what I need in my life. I don't want opposition. I'm looking for compatibility. And the compatibility that I am looking for is somebody that is sanguine. All right. Wow, this is actually getting good. I know I said that I was going to bridge this, but I'm feeling something. Come on now with these words. Taboo. You don't want to mess with somebody taboo. Forbidden. When somebody is taboo, forbidden. Don't mess with that. Don't mess with that. Because they are taboo. Forbidden. Observant. That means you are aware. You're alert. The Bible even says to be vigilant. That means to be alert, to be observant. Watch as well as pray. Oh, I feel something on here. My God.
Oblique.
Oblique. That means indirect. Like you said something oblique. Indirectly, it's an inference. It could even be something tacit, all right, that you didn't say audibly, but you inferred it. Come on now. Indirect. I like that. Disinterested. All right, we should know that. No, how did I get that wrong? See, it's the simple stuff you don't know. My God. This is why the Bible says, don't worry about the letter. The letter killeth, but the spirit maketh alive. Amen. I'd rather have the spirit rather than think I know everything and don't know it. Yeah, expiate. What does that mean? That means to redeem. I'm expiated by his love. I'm redeemed. Come on through here. Absolve. That means to what? To forgive. Same thing as expiate. God has absolved. Amen. Our sins because of the shedding of the blood. The blood, that crimson blood. Absolve, forgive. All right. Foment. That means to provoke. You know, I know some people, you may hear people in church when they say, oh, we invoke the presence of the Lord. But what they're really saying is we foment. We're provoking his presence by our adulation of him. In other words, we're looking for the ambiance of his glory to be resonated, thus having a better experience, a better experience. You know, I can kind of relate this, and I know let me just be quick. Let me be nimble with it. I know how the Bible says that when Jesus had found out that at the party, at the wedding, that they were out of wine, you know, God, Jesus ameliorated that situation by giving them wine that was better than what they had. Come on here. In other words, his presence, hallelujah, was invoked and changed the course and was ameliorated by his glory. Hallelujah. All right, let me stop. Praises to his high name. Callous. That was callous what Mr. Brooks did. It was cold and callous. It was heartless. Centurion. Somebody that, let me think. Would it be booming? Yeah, a stentorian voice, a booming voice. All right, we got to get this disinterested, impartial. Right, I should have known. Why didn't I get that the first time? I knew that, but whatever. One more impartial. All right, we're going to do it one more time. Extenuate, what does that mean? That means mitigating. If it was unmitigating, it would be absolute. Like if I said Mr. Brooks was an unmitigating fool, that's absolutely. In other words, you're damn right. Flesh and blood did not reveal that. Dirty, sordid. That means dirty. Something, yeah, you should be shameful, I think, right? Yeah. But I thought it meant, okay, I know the definition too. Dirty and unpleasant. Sordid, that could be grimy. Grim or grimy, that could mean dirty. Murky, that could mean dark. Esteem, somebody respected. Deference. Contrive. Contrive means manage to do something that is difficult. Elated, that means you're happy. I'm elated that God extended another opportunity of life for me. And thusly we give his name praise. Say, ah, my. The power of words. Reprehensible. That's blameworthy. Amen. If you did something reprehensible, that means your actions reflect that which is repugnant. And this is why we should repent. Because when we repent, God redeems us. He expiates us, ha-ta-ta-ta, by his potent blood, the powerful blood that even got him up in 3 days that he spoke about. Because he said, if you tear this body down, hallelujah, amen, I'll raise it back up. My God. All right. Obstreperous. That's Mr. Brooks. He was obstreperous. Unruly. What's constituted him being removed. it was obstruct. You know what? I think Judge Doro may have meant, said that, and I think she had issues trying to enunciate it. I think she did say it. I have trouble saying that word. Obstreperous defendant or onerous. That's difficult. Onerous or onerous. Onerous.
Onerous.
Difficult. Flippant, flippant. Somebody disrespectful. All right, and that is it for now. Thank you for listening to my vocabulary time.